Last week here, we discussed what's being called by the mainstream media the, quote, new face of heroin.
We want to tell you about a skyrocketing threat in suburban communities across the country tonight. A steady supply of cheap and powerful heroin being marketed with fashionable names and sold directly to teens and children.
The statistics alone are alarming. The number of heroin users has nearly doubled in just the past 3 years. Even more surprising may be the face of the new addicts.
The number of Americans using heroin has doubled over the last decade.
A heroin high, euphoric effects with nightmarish consequences. And police say there's a good chance the next addict could be your child.
It is no longer hiding in the shadows of seedy downtown alleyways. Heroin has a new home, bringing its highly addictive, oftentimes deadly power to the white picket tree-lined streets of suburbia.
I'm sorry, sometimes those intros just make me laugh. The white picket fences of suburbia. So if the suburbs are the new face, will they end up looking like the old face? Here's a little montage that we put together of the Lower East Side in the 70s and 80s, which was notoriously ravaged by drugs like heroin, but also economic misfortune. Is this the future of our suburban landscapes, especially coming off the recession where wealth is pretty much being condensed to cities like New York, Houston, and Miami? Julia, you did a lot of research in Detroit, not a suburb, but what did you see in terms of the economic status of a lot of users, where they came from, and how they got involved with the drug?
Well, our research specifically looked for people who had been doing heroin for a number of years and who had no intent to quit. So there's no real relationship with the suburban phenomena, but we have seen an increase in availability of heroin on the streets of Detroit and an increase in purity. So it doesn't surprise me that that would migrate out into the suburbs, especially when the suburban population is used to taking the prescription forms of opiates. And healthcare has been such an issue. So they wind up trying to service that need through what's available on the street.
The suburbs are the new face of poverty. Most people do still live in the cities who are poor. But over the past decade, as Brookings has documented, the rate of poverty has risen twice as quickly in the suburbs as it did in the cities. And what that represents is a reversal of long-term trends of people rising to the middle class and leaving cities for the suburbs many decades ago. And now more people who, you know, becoming prosperous and wanting to move back into the cities. Mm-hmm. And that's pushing poor people out. And more poor people are living in the suburbs. And, you know, how it affects the heroin trade is interesting. I mean, you've got to imagine it's simpler to be a drug dealer in the cities when you're on a, you know, you can stand on the corner and interact with all these people. But in the suburbs, I mean, it's not something I really saw driving in the tree-lined subdivisions, poor as they might have been. Mm-hmm. So it's certainly on the surface something that's not as obvious when you're in your car driving around.
The last suburban heroin story, there's one of these about every 10 years, was Plano, Texas, which is a rich Texas suburb with lots of, you know, oil company executive parents who were, you know, away in Bahrain or wherever, and the kids were partying with heroin. What's happening now on the heroin front, it seems to me, is two things. The price of heroin has fallen. Let us say the purity of a bag of heroin has gone way up. And yes, it's now usable by snorting rather than by injection. In addition, the prescription opiates have been a gateway.
Yes.
People start on oxycodone or hydrocodone, get strung out, and then trade down because heroin's cheaper. Mm-hmm. Or now that there's a big crackdown on the prescription mills, people who are getting prescription opioids and can't get them anymore are going to heroin because there's nothing else available.